A quick disclaimer, I am being paid to make this video by the European Union and NS Kojari as part of a series meant to share several wonderful geologic features within the nation of Slovakia. What you are looking at is the remains of Central Europe's last volcanic eruption, well, at least if we exclude Germany from this group of nations. Here, in Romania's central region, is a massive now lake-filled explosion crater termed a mare, where 27,000 years ago a powerful eruption occurred, resulting in the formation of this 300-meter deep and 1.5-kilometer-wide feature. Yet, Ciomadul is not the only geologically recent volcano to have erupted within Central Europe. As within Slovakia is a 100-meter-high volcanic vent that is seemingly hidden away on a hillside 4 kilometers east-southeast of the village of Orovanica. This feature is known as Putikov vrsok and in a geologic sense did not originate so long ago, as while modern humans were not in Europe to witness its eruption, Neanderthals likely once lived in the vicinity and may have witnessed the spectacular lava fountains this vent created. As Putikov vrsok erupted once a mere 102,000 years ago. During this eruption, basinite composition lava was ejected in several hundred meter high lava fountains, which then fell back to the ground, creating a lava flow of molten rock which advanced 3,000 meters before the eruption ended. The outline of the 3 square kilometer or 1.16 square mile patch of ground this ancient lava flow covered can still be seen today, as the dark-colored volcanic rocks shaded this region a different hue than the surrounding forest. With such a young volcanic eruption, you might ask, is there a chance that Slovakia will be the site of another volcanic eruption in my lifetime? To this, I say it's theoretically possible, but realistically it's unlikely, as the chance of such an occurrence is absurdly low, just barely being above zero. As during the last 3.5 million years, Slovakia has been the site of 15 volcanic eruptions, with one eruption occurring on average every approximately 230,000 years. Yet, this metric doesn't tell the whole story, as all volcanic eruptions during the last 500,000 years of the country occurred in two separate volcanic fields. That is, not a single towering volcanic cone, but rather a series of individual small to medium-sized vents, which only erupt once and then never erupt again due to a weak supply of molten rock underlying these regions. 7 of these 8 eruptions in the last 1.5 million years occurred in a 440 square kilometer region known as the Nógrád-Gömör volcanic field. The most notable of the vents in this field involves the remains of a volcanic neck which erupted 990,000 years ago. Yet, you might notice that none of this field's eruptions are any younger than 780,000 years in age. That is, because this volcanic field, which was active intermittently between 7.0 and 0.78 million years ago, has now been extinct for some time and will never erupt again. Thus, the numerous eruptions that occurred geologically recently in this field are throwing off the overall average, meaning the odds of a volcanic eruption are far lower than once every 230,000 years. And even in the highly unlikely event a regional volcanic eruption was to unexpectedly occur, in my opinion, there would be months to years of warning signs beforehand. As the only area which today could theoretically produce a future volcanic eruption is an 830 square kilometer region that largely encompasses the remains of the long-extinct Szakács supervolcano. This region is known as the Central Slovakia volcanic field, where vents of a basaltic to basinite composition used weak points in the crust such as fault lines as paths of least resistance to erupt from. The formation of the Putikov vrsok cinder cone likely occurred over a brief 2-week-long eruption where only minor amounts of ash were ejected through intermittent Strombolian explosions that threw bombs of lava in a several hundred meter radius. The advancing lava flows had a basinite composition and were quite runny, eventually causing a section of the Huron River to divert further to the north. If you were to visit this extinct cinder cone today, the lava rocks you might find would look like those seen in this photograph.